The School of Life is in session, and I am your status quo disruptor, Chioma Agwunobi. Now, today we'll be looking at personal development. Why? Because we've come into the last month in the first quarter of the year. So we're looking at it that the year is running so fast and I haven't achieved so much. It's not too late. So it's important for us right now to take stock and position ourselves for where we need to be for the rest of the year. And one way to do that is to ensure we have a personal development plan or personal development goals set for ourselves for the year. Okay. But before we get into what personal development is in the first place, what is development? Development is said to be an event constituting a new stage in a changing situation. In essence, personal development now becomes an investment you make in yourself to help manage you, your life more effectively and prepare you for the things that will come, okay? Even the unexpected things. So personal development helps put you on the offensive in life rather than putting you on the defensive, okay? Now, there are some key areas of our lives that we really need to build our personal development goals and plans around, which is your mental, spiritual, emotional, social, and even your physical well-being. Okay, these are the key areas our personal well-being plans and goals have to be centered around. Achieving your personal development plans will come with its own challenges. In fact, personal development is a challenge. It's like having an account. Now, you cannot go to your bank account to make withdrawals if you have not made deposits, right? If you keep making withdrawals on yourself without making deposits in yourself, you're going to run out. You're going to run dry before the end of the year. You're going to have a situation where you feel like you feel practically empty. Yes, because you're running on empty. Okay, so it's important. Once we understand how important and critical this is, it now begins to give us the strength we need to face the challenges and the obstacles that will come in the process of achieving those goals. There are five pointers I need to have on your fingertips. One is face your fears, okay? Fear of the unknown, fear of failure, fear of what people will say, fear of what if, fear of what if not. And today I ask you, if you're afraid to fall, then how will you ever walk? If you're afraid to fail, then how will you ever know if you'll succeed in that thing? The second thing you need to know is this: self-development is a lifelong process. And so I think that sort of affects a lot of us a little bit. So because you feel it's a lifelong process where we become laid back, it's lifelong, but the time to start is now, not tomorrow, not next year. No, don't join the next batch. Join this batch. Don't sign up for that exam tomorrow, or don't sign up for it next year. Sign up for it now. For number three, it is important for you to set goals. Now, have you gone shopping before without having your shopping list? You find yourself buying so many things you don't need, you never really even intended to. So there's a difference between what you need and what you want. So what your goal setting does is it helps you separate between what you need and what you want, and it helps keep you on track. So you have to set your goals and you have to pursue it. Now, in setting your goals, I need you to have this at the back of your mind. You can achieve those goals you have set. You can do it. Believe in you. Believe in your goals. Believe in your dreams. Your dreams are very valid. Okay? Number four, please be confident. Now, you need to know this. I always say this. Life doesn't give you what you deserve. Life gives you what you demand. And making a demand comes from a place of confidence, okay? Now, that is what will make you walk into an office where you have been told no before. That is what will make you approach an investor that has said no or turned down your proposal. It is time for you to rise, believe in you, believe in your visions and your dreams, and confidently pursue them. Number five is this: I need you to know that your potentials are limitless. So please don't limit yourself. You have so much treasure buried in you. But listen, just like every natural resource you find here on earth, you find them buried in the belly of the earth. You have to dig for them. You have to work for them. You have to find them. You have to now refine them. Okay, so whether you're gold, your diamond, your crude oil, your coal, you always have to look at them and you have to put some work to get in them. It's the same thing with the potentials that you have. It's the same thing with the resources God has placed in you. All you have to do is to dig them out. And one of such ways to do that is by having your goals, having your personal development plans. Go out there, grab the certification, go out there, read that book, meet that person, network. Don't do it tomorrow. Don't do it next year. Don't join the next batch. Do it now. And you will be amazed at the discovery you make. And that discovery is you. Personal development helps you become aware of you because a lot of introspection goes on. You have to go in and search within you. So it now begins to unveil you to you. You now become a lot more confident in you. And that's all you need. The world is waiting for you. The moment you discover you, the world will fall at your feet. See you at the top. If nobody believes in you, believe in yourself. If for nothing, know that I believe in you. I am Chioma Agwunobi, your status quo disruptor. Please do like, comment, and share.